guys, welcome back to the channel. Thank you for tuning in. I do apologize for the sound quality in this room. I do plan on filming the next handful of videos in here, so I will try to do something about the echo because I know it probably gets kind of annoying. I apologize for right now, we'll get it fixed. It's freezing cold outside and my truck's completely back to stock anyway, so it's pointless of me going outside filming myself in front of a completely stock truck. It's not gonna get any more views than me sitting right here at my desk, although there is typically more action when I do so. Speaking of trucks, my new truck is expected to arrive somewhere in the next 8 to 12 week time frame. So somewhere in April, we should have the new truck. It is legitimate. My old truck, my Silverado, will probably be leaving us by the end of this month. So probably in the next 2-3 weeks. I will have more information to you guys, I swear, next week and next week's upload. I'm going to kind of reveal what we bought and what we're going with, just because I've been clickbaiting you guys for probably like a year now. If you think you know which truck we did get for the next build on this channel, leave a comment. I'd love to see what you guys think. For this video though, I want to go through like the 5 things I wish I could change about my truck and things that I would change if I were keeping it long term, if that makes sense. There's 2 things I wish I would have done in my time owning it. Number 1 thing I wish I would have tried is polished wheels. I always wanted to try polished wheels on a truck, especially because the front and rear bumpers were chrome, so was the grill, and then I had all the badges around the side, they were all chrome, and then when I had the tow mirrors on, the tow mirror caps were chrome. I think polished wheels would have looked really good on the truck. My dude out in California, SoCal_8.1, photoshopped my truck with his wheels on it, and it did look pretty good. Once again, they were in the plan. I did want to get a set of polished wheels for the truck to try on, because I never tried on a set of polished wheels. I had my stock wheels, I had my black rhinos, the matte black. We tried on a set of polished black 12 wides, and then we tried on a set of 20-inch, you know, like replica snowflakes that were also powder-coated black. So I never tried polished wheels, always wanted to, but I guess a motorcycle accident and not being able to walk for 6 months kind of got in the way. Number 2, I wish I would have color matched the truck. Now I did Photoshop my truck color matched, and I think it looks really good. And then if you want to see a really good truck that is completely white and black, same truck, check out LMS Crew on Instagram and on YouTube here. His truck is pretty sick. It's pretty much what mine would look like, except for I wouldn't have the lean, I'd have the rake. I always wanted to try it. I wanted to either vinyl wrap it myself and or try to paint match it myself, but once again, life kind of got in the way the past 3 years, you know, moving multiple places and finding different jobs, and just didn't work. So now in life, I'm a little bit more settled down. So if we were able to do it again, we would probably do that, but never got to paint match, never got to try polished wheels. Wish I would have done both, but it's a little too late at this point. Now for the 5 things I would do if I were keeping the truck. Number 1, lift setup. Not gonna hate on MotoFab whatsoever. I loved my MotoFab setup with the 2-inch blocks in the rear, the 2.5-inch level up front, and the upper control arm. It's a good cheap setup, it's good for people on a budget, but if I were keeping a truck for 100, 150,000 miles, I would buy a legitimate lift kit. One, just so I could actually clear the 33-inch tire a lot better. Two, just for ride quality. So I would have probably went with like a 3, maybe 3.5-inch like legitimate lift kit with upper control arms, lower control arms, maybe tie rod ends, maybe some steering components, and you know, like a legitimate strut up front, so we're not riding on factory struts with a puck on top of it. And then for the rear, we would have done shocks, which I did anyways, and then like a nicer block set. So I would have went with a legitimate lift. So it costs more money, obviously. I knew I wasn't gonna keep this truck long term, so we went the cheaper route, and I'm very happy with my MotoFab setup. But if we were keeping the truck, I'd do a legit lift kit and all the other suspension components to make the ride quality top notch. Number 2, intakes. So I ran a 63 series K&N Porter intake open box, which I ran on multiple vehicles before and I was always happy with them, until this truck when I did the actual results, and I'll link that video up here. Being an open box system, I learned that it's really not the best system for the trucks, because I mean, it's perfect when you're a wide open throttle. It's sucking in all kinds of cool air, but the problem is when you sit at red lights and you're daily driving and you're sitting at stop signs and stuff like that, it's sucking in all that hot engine air that is just like accumulating and thus giving you actually worse performance. So what I would have gone with, and what I would recommend you guys going with, is an S&B, like a closed system cold air intake, if that makes sense. So that's what we'll be doing on the next truck too. We'll do a closed box, and then we'll do the testing and find all the results with it. But a closed cooled air intake is what I would go with. Number three, exhaust. So I was very happy with my Catback 3-inch MBRP installer series exhaust. I liked it. It wasn't too loud. It was a nice rumble. But if I were keeping the truck, I love the V8 Silverados, like the 5.3 or 6.2 Silverados with a full exhaust, not duals. I don't like duals. Headers, and then maybe even throw a cam in there. But once again, that setup gets kind of costly, because once you do that, you got to get legitimate tuning, and then you'll probably have to go through a couple transmissions. Obviously a setup that you want to have a daily driver for, because you know, once you start getting into power, that's when you kind of start breaking things. So that's why we did the MBRP 3-inch Catback. But if we were keeping the truck, I'd go with a full system and maybe a couple engine components as well to go along with that. And speaking of tuning, if I were to keep the truck, I would tune out AFM completely. Now, obviously we ran the Range Technologies AFM disabler, but all it really did was trick the computer to think that there was a load on the truck at all times, so it never went into four-cylinder mode. So if we were to keep the truck, I would legitimately go into the engine, take out the parts that make AFM up, and then get a legitimate tune, so that way the truck never thinks that there's ever a possibility to go into this four-cylinder mode. So we would get rid of that too. And then speaking of AFM mode and all that fun stuff, we'd probably run a catch can too. So one of the biggest problems with the 5.3 Silverados, probably 6.2s as well, is like the consumption of oil, or the burning of oil, or the oil leaving where it should be and going into engine components where it should not be. So a lot of guys do run catch cans on these trucks to catch that oil before it gets to said engine parts and, you know, makes them explode. So we'd probably run a catch can too. Never did. I kind of wanted to for this truck because it is relatively cheap and like an easy DIY mod, but we just never got around to it. And then for a bonus, number six, I would have, and I would obviously for views, but I'd run a gooseneck setup. They straight up, BMW makes a gooseneck ball, a turnover ball for the beds of half-ton pickup trucks. Now, obviously, a half-ton truck's only towing maybe 9,000 pounds, and it's kind of pushing it, I think, for half-tons. Could you just look at the thumbnail? Just think about the thumbnail of my truck with like a 30-foot gooseneck attached to it with like another truck sitting on top of it. I probably couldn't actually pull that, but it would look so sick, and it would just be fun to kind of try. So we'd do that. I guess another bonus, I didn't even think about it, for guys who do tow a lot, airbags. Airbags would have been a huge help with this truck, especially towing like a bigger box trailer, a loaded dump trailer, anything. These half-ton trucks like mine squat so bad it's unreal. So a nice set of airbags would be something nice as well to kind of handle all that weight so you don't get all that sag in the rear. So that's it, guys. Just kind of want to go through some of the things that I would have changed or would have done to my truck, and things that I would do if I were keeping it long term. Hope somebody found this video interesting and informational. I got a lot of stuff coming up. I'm probably filming in this office, like I said, for the next couple videos, at least until a new truck comes in April. I do have some stuff I think that y'all are gonna like, so please stay tuned. Appreciate everyone who has subscribed so far. We're getting pretty close to 10,000 subscribers, which is mind-blowing. And that's about it, guys. So thank you guys for watching. Like the video if you haven't already. Subscribe, join the family, join the builds, and I'll see y'all guys next week. Peace.